Well, thanks so much, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to introduce Kelly Norris, who is here from Wyoming. And Kelly, I'm so pleased you could join us today on such short notice. Kelly is currently a resident of Cheyenne, Wyoming. She's lived around the state in her work with the Forestry Division. Kelly has worked for the Wyoming State Forestry Division for more than 13 years. She has a degree in forestry from the University of Wisconsin. And in January, Governor Gordon appointed her to serve as our interim state forester for the state of Wyoming. Kelly has incredible experience working as a forester for both the state of Wyoming and before that, the U.S. Forest Service. So she has years worth of critical on-the-ground knowledge as a valuable resource for the many issues that we're going to be discussing here today. Kelly, congratulations again on your appointment. Thanks so much for joining us today from Wyoming in Washington.
Bet she wishes back home.
Thank you. Thank you, Chairman Manchin, Ranking Member Barrasso, and members of the committee for the opportunity to testify on behalf of Wyoming State Forestry Division. My name is Kelly Norris, and I'm the interim Wyoming State Forester. The integration and cooperation of federal, state, and county cooperators has been a success for Wyoming. Our firefighter entities have adapted and evolved over decades to become a more effective and efficient alliance whose main focus is protecting life and our valuable communities, infrastructure, grasslands, and forests. Wyoming State Forestry is tasked with wildfire suppression and management on 3.5 million acres of state trust land and coordinating suppression on 29 million acres of private land. 48% of the state is federally owned. The BLM manages 18 million acres, the Forest Service manages 9 million acres, and the BIA manages 2.2 million acres, each having their respective suppression responsibilities. Wyoming State Forestry is an extremely small organization. We depend almost exclusively on local county volunteers and our federal partners for initial attack. State Forestry supports the state's initial attack response with our HeliTAC, single engine air tankers, and the inmate conservation crew. In Wyoming, we believe in the closest resources response concept. Typically, that means our county cooperators will be the first firefighters arriving to the wildfire. Other times, it might be the BLM or U.S. Forest Service firefighters who are responding first to a wildfire. Everyone coordinates to suppress wildfire, no matter the jurisdictional responsibility. A great example of interagency cooperation is our aviation program. We contract our helicopter and manage our program with one permanent and four seasonal employees. The Medicine Bow Route National Forest and Thunder Basin National Grasslands supports our HeliTAC program by providing a trained employee to assist us in managing it. Two detailers are also provided by the local national forest to help support the program. The committee is aware of the immediate issue with recruitment and retention for federal firefighters. This is also a challenge for our state and county fire districts. As veteran firefighters retire, they are not being replaced at the same rate. The need to effectively recruit within our county volunteer fire districts is a big concern that Wyoming is looking to address. We need to work together to find solutions that meet the needs of our wildland fire community. There will not be a one-size-fits-all solution, as the need will have to be addressed at all levels. I would like to transition the conversation to proactively managing for the health of Wyoming's forests. A recent study from the Nature Conservancy found that Wyoming's forests provided approximately $26 billion of economic value every year. Our forests are the headwaters to four of the nation's main river basins and provide more than just board feet sold. They should be managed appropriately for the values they provide, such as water supply and storage, wildlife habitat, recreation and tourism, and carbon storage. Wildfire and forest health threats know no boundaries, and there is an urgent need for active forest management. Last year's Fish Creek Fire, located in the Black Hills, was stopped in a fuel break treatment area. The fuel break saved multiple homes while helping bring the fire down in intensity and gave our firefighters the opportunity to control the wildfire safely and effectively. State agencies must be a part of the solution to getting more management done on the ground with our federal forests. Wyoming State Forestry has increased its G&A program successfully and sold 11 million board feet of federal timber in our 2022 fiscal year. However, G&A can be more than assisting federal partners with timber sales. G&A can provide flexibility needed through our state contracting systems to complete a wide variety of projects for our federal partners. In conclusion, thank you for the opportunity to appear before the committee today. Wildland fire response continues to be one of the most challenging problems our agency faces. This primary mission is further complicated by the persistent challenges with recruitment and retention of our wildland firefighters. The other side to the wildfire response problem is long-term, as it relates to the health of our forests. We need to address how we continue to manage our forests by making strategic investments in them. We must continue to implement more active forest management on all ownerships. Thank you.